So I'm Jennifer Allum. I live in London, in the UK, and I'm a violinist. And I'm playing at this festival with Eddie Prévost and Marjolaine Charbin, both of whom I met through the workshop that Eddie has been running in London since about 1990, I think. And I've been going for about the last 5 or 6 years.
I play the piano and I play also with objects inside the strings. I also play it in a classical way on the keyboard. I just mix these different techniques. And it's been a few years now that I'm only doing improvisation. And also a little bit of, let's say, open compositions. So yeah, that's what I'm doing, and what I do with Eddie and Jenny is basically what I do with everybody.
Yes, so I was at York, which is quite academic. Things like Boulez, Burt Whistle, which isn't even new now, but that was kind of the music that was happening. And then I went to Goldsmiths, where it was freer, and I think staff and also students that I met there were more interested in a kind of broader understanding of what experimental and new music was. So that was when I became properly aware, I think, of improvisation and things like the scratch orchestra and so on.
Different people coming from jazz or coming from classical education, or even some people not coming from music background at all, but more from artist, you know, artistic conceptual side of things. And then all these people, you know, just work with sound basically, and in this performance way, or yeah, it's quite a broad array of approaches and activity. Bands like AMM, in which Eddie was involved, were used to play in front of thousands of people, because they were at this time. You know, it was the time of big festivals and as you say, all the hippie wave and open way of thinking that was a bit that it was there to break establishment.
I think what we're doing here is improvised music, certainly as I understand it. And what I've seen from the festival so far has been improvised and music post 1930, maybe, the things that I've heard, composed music. So it seems to be quite harmonious here. I think sometimes the programming of improvised and composed music can sometimes be a bit confused. I haven't felt that here, but I suppose maybe it's worth mentioning, I play, have played and sort of loosely have a quartet with which I play that we do experimental new music. So things like Vandelweiser and post-scratch orchestra composers, the kind of second, third generation. But it feels mentally very different approaching that. I'm very clearly playing someone's music, whereas here is we're playing our music.
It's true that if you're referring to the 60s or 70s, where I wouldn't say it all started, because it has roots everywhere. So it started from the maybe from the prehistoric, you know, ages, when, you know, we first pick up a stone and make a sound and giving it social meaning and all that. So it's an essential way of, you know, it's just playing music basically.
Hopefully, people are inquisitive naturally, and by virtue of having something which is available, which they can find out about, which is an accessible environment that they don't feel difficult coming into, which maybe going into a university they would be, maybe, that's a start. And all you can do is have concerts, have people playing, and hopefully people will come, and then the quality of the music should be what encourages people to come again. I don't think any level of gimmick or kind of dumbing down, I don't think it helps in the long run. And certainly in London we have, I think, quite a lot of initiatives where they try and make things more accessible, like adding DJs to string quartets, and, you know, I don't find that interesting, and the people that want to hear this music will find it, as long as it's, you know, reasonably friendly and welcoming and there, and it's happening, I think they'll come.
It's not so much about reacting, it's, you know, it's not the first shout anymore. Now it's getting more subtle, more complex. It becomes really a proper way of creating music that doesn't have to fight against something, you know? It's in itself, it's a place to be, it's a place to create, collectively and individually. And I think my generation, we don't have in mind so much like of protest. I mean, of course we do, it is political, you know, but it's through doing it that we express this, but it's more about the music itself.
One of the concerts last night was completely packed. And people seemed very eager to see what was happening. So that was very positive, and a very mixed audience of young and old, which is really nice. It seems people seem to know what's happening. Yeah.
Of course, we would like sometimes to have more people coming to our gigs to have more recognition in the media, for instance, because if people don't know it exists, how are they going to come? So this takes time, and maybe, you know, maybe in 10 years, 20 years, it would be a bit different. I don't know. We'll see.